The concept of worship. All praise is due to Allah, the Lord of all worlds, who says in his ever glorious book, "Verily Allah is my Lord and your Lord. So worship him alone. This is a straight way. I bear witness that there is no God but Allah and that Muhammad is his servant and messenger. May Allah's peace and blessing be upon him, his household, companions, and upon those who follow their path to the Day of Judgment." Worship has a great status and supreme position, as it is ultimate purpose for which the Almighty Allah has created all creatures. He, the Most High, said, "I created jinn and mankind only to worship me," and said, "We never sent any messenger before you, Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, without revealing to him that there is no God but me, so worship me." Moreover, worship is a duty of humans throughout all of their lives. Al-Hasan al-Basri said, "There is nothing to stop believers' good deeds but death." When contemplating the Islamic Sharia, one finds that worship has two implications, a broad and general meaning, which cover all paths of goodness, such as working, having good manners, truthfulness, pardoning one who behaves wrongly, reconciliation between people, spending on one's family, as well as all other good deeds. The Almighty Allah said, "There is no good in the most of their secret talk, except in commanding charity or good or reconciliation between people to anyone who does these things, seeking to please Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, we shall give a rich reward." Our Prophet, peace be upon him, said, "There is sadaqah, a charity to be given for every joint of the human body, as a sign of gratitude to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Every day that the sun rises, to judge justly between two persons is regarded as a charity. And to help a man concerning his riding animal, by helping him to ride it or by lifting his luggage on it, it's also regarding as a charity. And saying a good word is also charity. And every step taken in one's way to offer the prayer in the mosque, it's also charity. And to remove harmful things from the way is also charity. In addition, development of the earth throughout agriculture, industry, and perform any work properly and skillfully in order to benefit the whole society and achieve the advancement and progress of the one's homeland are all acts of worship that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala loves and wants. That Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala loves and wants his servant to achieve. As He the Most High said, "It is He who brought you into being from earth and settle you on it." The Prophet, peace be upon him, said, "The most beloved people to Allah are those who are most beneficial to people. The most beloved deeds to Allah is to make Muslim happy and to remove one of his troubles or to pay his debt on his behalf or to feed his hunger, and that I walk with a brother to fulfill one of his needs is more beloved to me than that's to seclude yourself in the mosque of Medina for a month. Whoever suppress his rage, even though he could fulfill his anger if he wished, Allah will secure his heart on the day of resurrection. Whosoever walk with his brother regarding a needs until he secure it from him, then Allah Almighty will make his footing firm across the bridge on the day when the footings are shaken." The second meaning of worship is a special meaning, which include the establishment of rituals of Islam, such as performance of prayers, paying zakah, fasting, and pilgrimage. The Almighty Allah said, observe the obligatory prayers. Observe the obligatory prayers, especially the middle prayer, and stand in true devotion to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You who believe, fasting is prescribed for you, as it was prescribed for those before you, so that you may be mindful of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Keep up the prayer and pay the prescribed alms. Whatever good for you, store up for yourself, you will find it with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Pilgrimage to the house is duty owed to Allah. So pilgrimage to the house is duty owed to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala by people who are able to undertake it. Those who reject this should know that Allah has no need of anyone. All praise is due to Allah, Lord of the world. May Allah peace and blessing be upon Prophet Muhammad, his companion and followers. We stress that a bright person is the one who strikes a balance between the fulfillment of the duty imposed by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, such as prayer, fasting, zakah, and hajj, and development of the universe and adherence to noble values. We also affirm that acts of worship in their specific meaning don't bear fruit unless they affect one's conduct and behavior. As the Almighty Allah says, prayers restrain outrageous and unacceptable behavior. The Prophet, peace be upon him, said, When any one of you is observing fasting on a day, he should neither indulge in absence language nor should he raise the voice. And if anyone reveals him or try to cruel with him, he should say, I'm observing fast. He also, peace be upon him, said, I was sent to perfect good manners. O Allah, help us to remember you, to be grateful to you, and to perform your worship in the best manner. Thank you so much.